Welcome to another edition of Pittsburgh Sportsline at Olive Oil's Pizzeria, 930 Brookline Boulevard. We got a great crowd. You can tell by all the noise and the people here. It's a packed house. You may not have heard that intro, but thanks for everybody coming out. This is the famous birthday bash of Smokin' Jim Frazier and the Pittsburgh Sportsline Hall of Fame show. Now, I got a cake for him, and the symbolism, Smokin' Jim leaves wherever we go without saying a word. And I find out his nickname is Batman because they go, "Where'd Smokin' Jim go?" I go, "I don't know. That's Batman, right?" This is Batman. Happy birthday. Could you guys sing? Natalie, could we get you up here for a little singing? The most famous singer on Pittsburgh Sportsline. Everybody got to sing with her.
We all have to sing. Ready?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jim. Happy birthday to you.
Great. All right, cut the cake. Skeets Lewandowski sponsors What's On Your Mind. We're also, this show will be seen on Wednesday night, 7 o'clock to 8 on Verizon 32 everywhere in the Pittsburgh area. Only Comcast 7 in Bethel Park. And we have a Facebook page, 6,869 likes. Thank you for all those likes. This old dog learned a few new tricks, so if you haven't liked the page, I know you all got smartphones now because I got one. Just go there and like it right now. Save me the aggravation of checking. But I appreciate that. We're going to start the show. I got to ask Smokin' Jim Frazier, what's on your mind?
Thanks, Al Levine, the talking machine. And if you want the green,
don't break it.
You got to see Levine, the owner of a big can of spray tan.
You know it's not. It's au naturel on my deck, sipping green tea every day. That tan works 20 minutes a day. I'm trying to catch up to my brother from another mother.
I want to thank everybody for coming out. Big hand for the 2019 Pittsburgh Sportsline Hall of Fame class. Big hand for my favorite cousin that came in from Cleveland, Billy. Spent a lot of summers chasing girls in Cleveland at 7 and 8 years old. Big, I tried, brother. Big hand for Hall of Fame photographer Frank Fabus is in the house. Big hand for Pittsburgh Sportsline Hall of Famer Rachel is in the house. Nice big hand for the City of Pittsburgh Hall of Famer, the legendary coach. Coach Pat Carmack is here. You know, the Pittsburgh Pirates is doing a great job. I'm not a big Pittsburgh Pirate fan for the simple reason Josh Bell's getting way too much credit just because he can hit home runs. Reynolds is on pace to be Rookie of the Year. Adam Frazier tied a Major League Baseball record with 4 doubles in one game, and they don't get no credit because they ain't hitting home runs. It's because of the overrated home run that the great Barry Bonds started lifting those weights, started bulking up and getting stronger so he could get famous by hitting a home run. I'm boycotting baseball until Pete Rose is in the Hall of Fame. Pete Rose is the greatest baseball player that ever lived, but he can't get in the Hall of Fame because of gambling. Pete Rose is addicted to gambling, but he never cheated the game. Did Pete Rose cheat the game with his 4,000 hits? Did Pete Rose cheat the game with his Charlie Hustle hit first slides? Did Pete Rose cheat the game when he had 17 All-Star votes? Did Pete Rose cheat the game when he was League MVP, World Series MVP, and Rookie of the Year? What is a shame is Pete Rose is not in the Hall of Fame. One more big hand for the 2019 Pittsburgh Sportsline Hall of Fame class, the greatest class we ever had.
Is he done? I can't hear a thing, except he brought up something about somebody was a gambler. Well, he gambled in baseball, and there's a certain rule that everybody in baseball knows, except Smoking Jim, because he's not a baseball fan. He wears pirate garb because he got it for $5 and $3. The price is right, so he wears it. But he doesn't know pirates. And Pete Rose will be the greatest hitting baseball player to not get in the Hall of Fame, no matter what you rant about. And I got a little bit to say about Josh Bell, but first, I got to cover what you're saying about the home run. He also has 60 extra base hits. Did you even know that? You must have missed that. And he had almost 400 in the month of May. In June, he was at 208. But so what? He's still doing well. He started out hitting a few more home runs here. And he's got almost more home runs than Willie Stargell did two times in his career. So that means something to me. He's doing things that other people haven't done. And guess what? Girls like the long ball. I'll tell you, they do. Girls are fans of the long ball. It's not just these guys. But getting back to Josh Bell, I hear all this negative talk. Should he even be in the home run derby? How old is the young man? 24? Guess what? When I was 24, I thought I was indestructible. Well, thank you. I appreciate that. But thoughts don't carry that too well, but I understand. If he can't be in the home run derby, why even play baseball? It's part of the game. It's like an exhibition. What do you take, batting practice? Smoking Jim doesn't know. They do batting practice each day. They're hitting balls out of the ballpark every day.
With the cork bat.
No, with a regular bat. With a regular bat. You don't even know where the cork's at there, buddy. It might be on your wall in your house with all the sweetie pictures. But Smoking Jim's a great entertainer. Sorry to diffuse that, but Pete Rose will not get in the Hall of Fame, no matter what you say. Let's go on. We got great guests. We got a great show. I just found out who's in the Hall of Fame, and I'm impressed by each one of our guests. I don't know what the rules are, but Smoking Jim gets the only vote. I know it's my show, but he told me that's just how it is, so I respect him. I've had guests ask me, you know, how's this Hall of Fame work? And I go, you'll have to find out. We fly by the seat of our pants. We got the dreadlock DJ, ring announer, helping us. We got Sindel Taylor, fashion model extraordinaire, and look at the beautiful dress she's in. And we got Stevie Wonder, aka Smoking Jim Frazier here, back in the house again. Look at, if he's not a spitting image of Stevie Wonder, I can't see. He just won't recognize it. You don't look like Muhammad Ali. He was tall and thin. But let's carry on with the show. They're going to take control of it right now. I'll do some interviews. So let's see what happens.
I tell you what, we got to bring him up. You seen him on, if you got cable TV, if you got the satellite dish, you seen him. Amateur boxing, pro boxing, MMA, studio wrestling, professional boxing. And I tell you what, he was in the first class of the Pittsburgh Sportsline Hall of Fame. Bring him up, Dan the Man, Boogie Bogan.
welcome aboard.
Thank you.
Try to tell them your name.
Dan Bogan.
Thank you.
First off, don't pick on Jim. He's like me. He harkens back to the day when Pittsburgh had a Major League Baseball franchise. That's all. Not these last 25
Hold
years.
It. All you naysayers about bottom line Bob, he's a businessman. I never worried when the Galbraiths owned the Pirates
That's
in the
60s. That's because they won once in a while.
In the 70s. They won a bunch of them.
Well, first off, I want to thank you guys for having me. This is one of the highlights of my summer, one of the highlights of my year. I don't know how many people you ask that have to say no before you get to me. This is the
32.
That's this year or every year?
32.
This is the 6th annual Hall of Fame induction ceremony, the 5th year you've had me back, and I do thank you. I appreciate it seriously. Sincerely, thank you so much.
Another handshake.
I do appreciate it.
It's really hard to go through that list.
I do.
It is difficult, but thank you.
I have a lot of people that you were starting to talk about how you get in. The way I keep hearing it, year after year, there's about 30 people. Some of them are sports legends. Some of them are journalists. Some of them are media people. They are able to suggest people. There's about a list of 20, and it goes to one person to make the final call. Those people are unknown. They're secretive. And the person that makes the final call usually picks 5 or 6, and the others are available for next year's. And no one knows who that final person is, though everyone has rumors and have heard rumors as to who that might be. And I'm not going to name any names, but I can see him from here. He's saying Sherry Moore and superstitious and all that. But that's how you get into the class of the Hall of Fame. And really, and I've said this every year, it's kind of nice because after this, you'll be known as Hall of Fame and then your name after that. And it really is. We're here having fun. It's a good time. But it really does carry some weight, and it is a very nice thing, and thank you for having me. So
you're welcome again.
Thank you.
That's
only
3 times.
Well, I'm going to keep thanking you because I'd like to come back again.
4 times.
And actually, you guys have been nice to me for reasons that I have no way of knowing. Just dip underneath, that's all. Dip down.
No, we don't mind if you use the facilities.
You're prettier looking than I am. They'd probably be better if you stood there and just stayed. But you guys have been very kind to me, and as a result, I like doing stuff like this. And any time I've had somebody for fights, we had fights come up, you let me come on. You let me bring ring card girls. You let me bring fighters. You let me bring referees, promoters. You've been very kind to me. Daryl San Martino, it took a while, but we finally...
Wow, four tries.
And I appreciate you letting me do that, and I thank you for that, too. So thank you for just being nice to me for, I don't know why, but thank you so much. I do appreciate it. So if we're ready, let's start the festivities.
You're welcome again. Go ahead.
There's going to be some more. I'm going to want some more.
All right.
Our very first inductee. You got enough wire there?
It's like Jim doesn't have enough wire.
He wasn't even talking into the mic before. All that went by.
Quick impression. Jim Frazier's in the shower with a midget.
Get that out of my face.
Anyway. Our first.
This is a family show.
Jim's a family man. We're going to start this off right. We're not going to work our way up to nothing. These are all top-notch inductees this year. And this lady really she's a celebrity in my mind because I'm old enough to remember football back when guys like Dick Butkus were around.
Isn't that old?
Yeah, believe it or not, not as old as some people, but I'm close.
Okay.
He didn't even look at me. That
He's
was cool.
eating.
He heard me though.
No.
He's ignoring me.
He can't see and he can't hear. Just ignore him. That's Stevie.
Anyway, our first inductee is a 6-time award-winning author of 5-star books on Amazon. She's an author, an entrepreneur, an owner of the Cat's Meow Beauty Salon. And you guys know, I think, that I'm an animal person. The establishment began in 1997, and her first location was in Shadyside, Pennsylvania. Since then, she's gone to develop her own publishing company. 2015, her first book was titled Everyone Has a Story. It's about her life and domestic violence, media frenzy with ex-fiancé, NFL star, Hall of Famer, Jim Brown of the Cleveland Browns in August of 1986. Now, one of the things she's most proud of is that Cyrus Webb has called her book and deemed her book, hold on.
Here, I'll help you.
Thank you.
I'll help you again.
Thank you. Amongst the top, he named his book the top 25 summer reads of 2016, which that's a pretty high accomplishment. And this lady is a celebrity in my mind. I grew up watching her fiance play football. Guys like Jim and I know guys like, come on, Jack Ham, Jack Lambert, stars. The guys when football wasn't.
Quit reading off of that.
Wasn't prima donnas. Let's welcome our very first inductee into the 2019 class of Pittsburgh Sportsline Hall of Fame, Deborah Clark.
Oh, God.
Thanks, Sindel.
Okay.
Have a seat now.
Thank you.
Welcome aboard. Tell us your name, because I got lost with what he was saying.
Me too. Very interesting. My name is Deborah Clark, author Deborah Clark.
And it's been a couple years since you've been on the show. We've missed you.
Yeah. Well, it's been just a little over a year since our last show.
Right. No,
I missed you too.
That's right.
Too.
One of our last shows at Atria's.
Oh, yes.
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 We've moved on since we're at Olive Oil's Pizzeria.
Yes.
The pizza's delicious. I've only lost a finger. Smoking Jim bit it. Pepperoni's good too.
Well, it's his birthday. He's allowed to.
No, the 17th. It's early. He won't tell me what year.
Yeah.
It's a mystery.
That's okay. I said, once you get past a certain age, you don't like telling it. But since I had a media frenzy story, so everybody can calculate my age, so I just go on
we
and tell it.
We know about how are you. You're still beautiful.
Thank you so much.
Definitely.
And you're handsome.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Well, welcome aboard and congratulations on your
this
Hall of Fame
wonderful.
Induction there.
Thank you so much.
I'm honored to have you in our Pittsburgh Sportsline Hall of Fame.
Thank you. This is an honor. This is an honor. I just think about how we met. And how
hold it, our first
to
conversation
our first
was
conversation,
about 2 hours.
2 hours long.
The talking
over the
machine
phone.
Was
yeah,
listening.
I know. I did most of the talking then.
Yes, you did.
This is wonderful. Thank you so much.
No, you're welcome. And what are you up to now? What are you doing now?
I've been doing book tours, lectures, things of that nature.
I
and
see at certain libraries and
oh yeah.
I'll
be at the Penhills Library again for the Arts Festival.
Tell them.
It's this July. It'll be held at the Penhills Library on Stotler Road, I believe, and it'll be 3 days from Thursday through the weekend.
You don't know the date?
July 18th. It starts the
coming
18th.
Attractions for Deborah.
And it goes through to 22nd.
Go check her out. She's a great speaker and a great writer.
Thank you.
Great books.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I appreciate it so much.
You're welcome.
All right, did anybody else want to add anything? What about you, Jim? We haven't talked in a while. You've been very busy.
He already said he loves your legs, so I didn't want to bring that up again.
He said both of them.
He didn't say the other one. He just said he loves your legs.
He said one leg.
That's how all simple right. of a guy he
it's
is.
It's always a pleasure, and this is such an honor for me.
You're welcome again.
I love you both.
You're
welcome. You've been very instrumental in my success here in Pittsburgh.
Oh, well, thank you.
And I would like to say this. You are the only person in the history of Penn Hills that I love.
Well, I'll take that as a compliment. Thank you.
It truly is.
I know.
It is.
I know. But I'll accept that. Thank you. I appreciate that.
You better. Good.
Okay.
Run now.
All righty.
He may get crazy now.
Great job.
Yeah, there's four keys to Pittsburgh Sportsline, really. There's four things that Pittsburgh Sportsline stands on. The hosts, the guests, the sponsors, and the viewers. And I want to thank one of your sponsors. You meet people just by like being in the Hall of Fame. You meet people. Contacts. Skeets Lewandowski.
Yeah.
Contact me Saturday.
He look good in pink?
He does. He looks dynamic in pink. Dashing. He contacted me Saturday. I'm going to be ring announcing for the Bronson House Boxing Show. That'll be on July 20th. And I understand there's a big network that's going to be there filming this. Pittsburgh Sportsline will be there. The boys will be back in town. The Three Stooges will be back. So Bronson House, that's in Washington, PA. We got a good fight card, all amateur. Stop down there on July 20th for that.
5 o'clock p.m.
Bell time?
Yes. 5
nice and early. It's like a 10 to 12 card show. Be there for that.
Great, great venue.
I've never been there, but I keep hearing and reading a lot of things about it. It's an honor and a pleasure to be part of that show. I look forward to it. I'm bringing my A game. Maybe I'll get back into more boxing. Who knows?
That'd be great.
I'm done with the midget wrestlers. They short me on my pay, and they pay me in small bills. I've had enough of it.
We understand, and Smoking Jim heard you.
He can hear with selective hearing. Our next inductee into the 2019 class. The list is very, very voluminous, so I'm just going to skip and highlight it. The man
What's this voluminous?
It's a veritable plethora of information.
Okay. Plethora, I got that.
All right. He's the president of Enloe Shoes in Beaver Falls. His athletic activities include, amongst many, many things, He was a 1995-96 Beaver Falls Colts assistant coach, 97 to 2004 Beaver Falls Colts assistant coach and first base coach, 2005 to 2011 Beaver Falls Colts manager. And he's still active up to this day, but I think one of the coolest things about this guy is that the field was named, the Pony League field was named after this man. And that's your next inductee into the 2019 class of the Pittsburgh Sportsline Hall of Fame. Welcome, Mr. Bobby Middleman.
All right, folks. A Pittsburgh Sportsline first. Go Pitt.
Go Pitt. Here you go, guys. Here you go.
Can you hold that sweaty sweatshirt, please?
Now we're done with that. Now we're back to Pitt.
Have a seat, Bob.
Yeah, it was all Beaver Falls stuff. I've been born and raised there. I stayed there. I've been coaching at one level or another since 1969. My first love is Pitt football.
I understand. You write a lot about it.
I do. I have a on Facebook. I've got a page called Real Pitt Football Talk, no nonsense. It's more
check
nostalgia.
It out. Check
more
it out.
More nostalgia than anything else.
A lot of history on that.
Lots of history.
Greatest ever seen, Dwight Collins.
We had a lot of great ball players come out of Beaver Falls.
Not
He's
lately.
Probably the best.
Not lately. Not lately.
He likes to argue. He's a Hall of Famer. What are you doing arguing with him?
You can argue with me. We can talk about baseball. The only reason I'm up here.
Don't talk
is
baseball.
Because you didn't let, no, the only reason I'm up here and got this award is because you didn't let Pete Rose in. That's why. That's the only reason I'm up here.
No,
and
no.
I want to thank Pete Rose for that.
He signed that death notice that he can't be in.
Yeah, I know he did. And then
he doesn't understand
croaked,
that.
Yeah, but then the guy croaked a week later, so it was
it
his
doesn't
word
matter.
Against, his word against that piece of paper. He lost. He's out. He's not going to get in. But let me tell you another thing about that. If you want to talk about Pete Rose for a second, let me tell you something about him. I admired him as a player. I can go with everything you said.
Thank you.
But that son of a, you know what, got everything he wanted his whole life. That guy never wanted for anything. He got everything he wanted. Now there's something out there that he really wants and he can't get. And if they let him in the Hall of Fame someday, so be it. But I hope it's after he's 6 foot under.
I agree with you.
Okay.
He's not used
I won't
to somebody.
Argue, I won't argue about his ability as a baseball player. I can remember seeing him play his first game against the Pirates and how he hustled and Bob Prince made a big deal about it. There's no argument there.
I'm glad you agree with me. He's the greatest baseball player of all time.
Nah.
I don't know about that. But he's
change subjects.
He's in the top five of my lifetime. He's in the top five of
Let's
my lifetime.
Let's talk some
that's
Pitt.
Another, that's another.
Let's talk some Pitt. He
you
got you distracted.
Me back for that. That's my problem. I distract
you're,
everybody.
You're a wealth of information on sports.
What would
We've
you
talked
like to know
before.
About Pitt?
This year, what's going to happen?
This year, if you look at the schedule, they could very easily go 7-5. It all depends on how the offensive line does. I'm very happy that they.
How about their quarterback?
The guy drops back 7 steps instead of 3. The right tackle, who was one of the best guards in the country, ruined his whole shot at being a pro football player playing tackle.
Yeah.
He couldn't block me. At right tackle, he'd go back 7 steps, and all of a sudden he had a roll left. And some guys can roll left and throw right. And
yeah.
Right now, Kenny Pickett can't. So that's if you ask me, that's what I see.
I see that. I just
everybody
Smoking Jim doesn't acknowledge that, so we'll just carry on.
Well, you know what? What's going to happen after this show? I'd like to stick around about an iron. You know, I know he's the boxer, so I don't know. I'm going to have to put my money on your partner there.
Well, here, one
unless
thing
you're,
on
unless
boxing,
you can outrun him.
Did you see Muhammad Ali fight?
I did.
Now, look at Smoking Jim Frazier. He says with the sunglasses, he looks just like Muhammad Ali.
Let me see you sting. I want to hear the butterfly.
He looks like
the
Stevie
bee.
Wonder. Come on.
Well, how do you know Stevie Wonder can't fight? Did you ever see
I'm not him? Saying it. I'm talking about looks 100%.
I don't think so.
Well, he had glaucoma,
I just think this guy looks cool. He looks cool. If I never did like to wear sunglasses personally, so I can't
well,
help you.
He wears them all the time, even at night. So it's just that habit he got into. He had glaucoma, which he had surgery, and supposedly he texted me in big bold letters. I can see.
Since I know a little bit about everything, that has to do with the fluid behind the
behind the eye and the pressure that it puts on there. How were they able to fix that? Because I know I've been told
they
I'm
operated.
Prone to that.
The doctor couldn't speak English. So
they
sure
wouldn't tell him. He goes, she was a mighty fine-looking doctor.
Is that like the ball player that sits there after he made three errors and says no comment?
Yes.
Is that what you're talking about?
He's that guy.
Okay. Yeah, that guy. Oh, yeah, that's that commercial. Oh, there's that guy.
That's him.
Don't lay on those pillows. They don't work.
Now you understand.
Yes.
Well, congrats on being in our Hall of Fame.
Well, thank you. Did I waste enough of your time talking about absolutely nothing?
Yes.
Because I haven't talked about a thing. Is there anything else you want to know before you boot me out of here?
You already said 7-5 for Pitt.
7-5.
I got that out.
I do want to say, though, that if the offensive linemen that start the season do not produce, the guys behind them are better athletes than the guys that they replaced.
I appreciate
and
those
I think they've got a good offensive line coach. The one they had a couple years ago screwed everything up, and they're just recovering from that. I love Mark Whipple being there.
Yeah. Well, I appreciate your opinions and your knowledge. We just can't get much of it out because we got a show to do. And Dan's, look at him, he's chomping at the bit.
Hey, not me. He's a man. Let him talk.
Well, you got to come out of here. Good, throw me out. That's okay.
I got to.
Congratulations, sir.
Thank you. Appreciate you. Great job, Bob. And I think I speak for everybody here. We're all Pitt fans except for when they play Penn State.
Oh. Thanks, Stevie. You didn't see that coming.
Jeez.
Sorry, I can't. He's too easy. Looks like Stevie Wonder.
Another quick hype I'd like to throw out there. Last year, Stout Promotions did a Muay Thai show, the third one. I worked that show. Was entering. They announced they're going to have their first MMA show this year. There's rumors. It's not for sure yet. So, and I hate to mess things up. Usually when you announce things in advance, you queer the deal. You've messed things up. But there's rumors that October 12th, Stout Promotions will have their... they'll be doing their first MMA show. It'll be in, they're hoping for maybe Prince Cape Arena in South Point. They've got to cross all the T's and dot all the I's. I'll be doing that show. First time in 3 years, back in a cage where I belong, like the women say. And the next month after that.
No, I agree.
No argument. No one will. And the month after that, in November, around November 9th, they'll have their fourth Muay Thai kickboxing show. So when Jim contacted me to do this show, I says, well, you're going to have to talk to my agent this year. The guy from State Farm was totally baffled and said, who is this Jim Frazier guy, and why is he talking to me about this? That's the only agent I got. And that ties into our next guest. July 29th was her 40th anniversary with State Farm. Her agency in Mount Pleasant has been where she's lived for 25 years. They do home, auto, business, insurance, rollovers, annuities, mutual funds, banking products, mortgages. Sports line related things. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. She moved to Mount Lebanon in 2009. She still lives there. She enjoys running, boating, snow skiing, golfing, biking, and she even goes to the gym every day. I saw somebody jog in front of my house the other day. It inspired me. I got up and closed the blinds. She has 3 kids and 1 grandchild on the way. Please welcome your next inductee into the Pittsburgh Sportsline class of 2019, Rosemary Skaggs.
And you're dressed for sports.
I'm dressed for sports. There's a reason for that.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Welcome
whatever
aboard.
I did to do this was great.
I can't believe you had time to come into our show.
I know. The happiest day of my life was my 40th anniversary, July 29th. I've been sitting in that same seat for 40 years.
Wow. Didn't you even change it? It's the same seat. Oh my.
And the worst day of my life was when we buried my mom and my fiance died 3 hours later. So it was a bad day. But anyway, I found my way back.
Somehow you did.
Through sports.
What are those?
You hold those.
I'll hold the mic. Sure.
I just wanted to show you.
Take orders. Go ahead.
Yeah, I just want to show you. I went to every hockey game. I went to every Steeler game. And I went to 120-some Pirate games all in the same year. And that healed me. Seriously.
That is a great story.
Yeah.
The healing power of sports.
All of them, but these are a whole lot of them. Isn't that amazing?
Well, I have a question. When you go to a sports game like Smoke and Jim, I took him to his first baseball game. Mm-hmm. We're late to the game, and then we're there 3 innings, and he goes, talking machine, I got to go get my car. So we stayed three innings, and he left.
That's it, huh?
Yeah, gave that was his first time. Now the Pirates give him free tickets. He's missed some of the games and hasn't even gone. And he gets free tickets now.
Yeah. That's
so really God bless you and
thank you.
The healing power of sports. I love
that. You can't
that.
Believe how many people gave me tickets, too.
Really?
Yeah, when they found out where I was going and why I was doing it.
Well, that's a true nightmare what you went through.
Yeah, started giving me tickets, and I just went to everything.
Yeah.
It really helped.
Well, you like sports, too.
I love sports. You know that.
I sort of guessed. You're welcome.
Thanks for having me.
You're welcome. Congratulations. Thanks for sharing it. Thanks for bringing the tickets. And thanks for dressing like Smoking Jim tonight. We appreciate it.
On a serious note, in the MMA world, we lost a referee. Jimmy Chappell passed away a few weeks ago. I'd like to send out my condolences. I've got the pleasure to work with this man at least once, perhaps twice. He was a gentleman. He treated me nicely like you do for reasons that still are a mystery to me. He was just a very kind man and a very, very fantastic referee, and I'm sad to see him go. And in the pro wrestling world, Gentleman Joe Perry, who's a fixture around is in the hospital. He's in the hospital. He's not doing well, but he's on the mend. He's doing better. We want to wish Gentleman Joe Perry a quick, speedy, and full recovery. He's most associated right now with the Keystone State Wrestling Alliance, but he's been a wrestling fixture behind the scenes. He's been like the man behind the booth, the Wizard of Oz. He's involved in the business for most of his life. He's a great man from Springdale, and we want to wish him a quick and speedy recovery. Now, our next inductee, remember I said that we've got four pillars that Sportsline sits on?
Yes.
You've got the hosts, the fantastic hosts. You've got the guests. You've got the sponsors, but you've got the viewers. And our next inductee feels very honored to be inducted into this Pittsburgh Sportsline Hall of Fame. This evening, her induction comes from her loyalty to the show, not as a guest, but as a part of the viewing audience. She's an MVV, a most valuable viewer. So our next guest, our next inductee to the 2019 class of Pittsburgh Sportsline Hall of Fame is Bonnie Mallett. Bonnie Mallett.
I met her at Duke's Rib House and Grill. We were doing a show.
That's part of my speech, but go ahead.
Well, I am the talking machine.
Go for it.
Oh, a friend of mine from Green Tree, who's since changed his name to Rachel, was on my show that night at Duke's Rib House and Grill.
That's in my speech, too.
And there's a lady, because I always come to the show, unlike Stevie Smoking Jim Frazier. He comes later, just before it starts. I get there an hour and 10 minutes early. So I'm there, and there's a lady there, and I go, excuse me, are you here for our Pittsburgh Sportsline show? She goes, no, I'm here to see Billy.
That's in my speech, too.
Did I remember it well?
Is this on?
Yes. Okay. I'll let you do your speech then.
Go ahead. Say it.
So I didn't realize that she's a sports fan. I just thought she was a Billy, a.k.a. Rachel fan, because she loves Rachel, and they're good friends. And little did I know, because I kept saying, Bonnie's here, and I'm not sure if she even likes sports. And she'd yell, I love sports. And she goes to sporting events. She does it all. And that's why I'm honored to congratulate you on being in Pittsburgh Sportsline Hall of Fame. Carry on with that redundant speech now. Go ahead.
Okay. First time I came was to see a guest. It was Billy, now Rachel, who is a friend of mine. And I remembered being there 35 minutes early, and tonight I was 1 minute early. Sorry. I was there waiting, and you got there like right at the nick of time. Okay.
What happened?
I have attended shows for 5+ years in over 5 different venues. Atria's, Duke's, Holiday Lanes, Hollywood Lanes, Park House, and tonight Olive Oil's Pizzeria.
Do you need help?
Where I've attended 3 times before. At almost every show, so I was thinking he was going to be reading this, so that's why I made it like at the intro. So
you don't have to explain, just read.
At almost every show.
That's still good.
At almost every show, I saw someone who was part of my life years ago and enjoyed the great reunions. Also meeting Mr. Robert Burnett.
Skeets Lewandowski. Robert Burnett, he gave me a copy of his book. I enjoyed reading his book. The best has been meeting new people with unique interests, and I remember meeting you at Atria's. And these people out here, I met you guys. Okay. It's so great to see all these familiar faces. Okay. The best
else?
Has been meeting new people. You see another page here. The I'm best
nervous.
Has been meeting new people with unique interests, some of which are here tonight. He keeps talking in my ear. Some of which are here tonight. A shout out to Watson Chevrolet, to Victor Olive, who I met, who years later helped me with my car. The first show Alan said to me, sorry, this is redundant because he took away my speech, but the first show Alan said to me, I didn't know you like sports, only to find out I've been a Pittsburgh Steelers season ticket holder since the 70s. Wow. A member of Richie Hebner's fan club, a former Pittsburgh Pirate.
Roberta, he doesn't know Richie Hebner.
Roberta Clemente was my all-time favorite Pirate. Wow. I volunteered at Sickle Cell Society and met Willie Stargell, who was their sponsor. I love this because Alan's not interrupting. My children participated in lacrosse, softball, and bowling. My sports history can go on and on, but there isn't enough time to finish my list. Smokin' Jim is a great co-host with lots of good sports insight. Wonder if I bet on his predictions, I'd be a rich lady today.
Hold it.
Yes! Give her more time!
Let me do a disclaimer.
Give her another page.
I got to do a disclaimer. If you're going to bet, and if you haven't bet, don't start. If you're going to bet, do the opposite of Smoking Jim.
Where's Attila?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay. I enjoyed everything I participated in as far as the show and people I met, and I look forward to cheering on Attila Domas to his world record this
don't
fall.
Don't put your back to the camera. Keep your face on the camera.
Thank you for including me in your Hall of Fame, Alan and Smokin' Jim. One more thing. When I came to see Billy, he was a few minutes late because he stopped to get cookies. So I thought that was really special, and it's your birthday. So here's some Max and Irma's fresh baked cookies.
I had a dream last night about Max and Irma's cookies.
Those are Max and Irma's cookies for you.
Thank you.
Continue.
And Carol and Gio. And I love seeing everybody. And these guys out here.
That's Jose and Colleen.
Okay. Well, can they come in? I met Jose and Colleen.
Yes. They acknowledge that.
Okay. So I just thought cookies was the thing to do because Billy, that was like. So, and I've probably met over.
Words?
And I've added about 150 people to my Facebook since I've come to the show. So
wow,
it's been great. So
I'm glad I could interrupt you.
And Alan, thank you for taking half of my speech.
Your Indian name would be Steals One's Thunder. I know you guys, we were at a picnic that somebody was supposed to come to and didn't make it.
He gave no excuse.
I know. He heard I was going to be there, and I don't blame him. I wouldn't come if I knew I was going to be there either. I know how much you appreciate guys like your film crew. Frank Fabus, who makes us famous, and especially, this is I think the fifth or sixth time I've been here, Olive Oil's Pizza. They do make one of the best pizzas in Pittsburgh. I'm going to get two, at least one, maybe two to go when we're done here. I always do
one
that.
One for the dog.
Well, he'll get his share, but
okay.
I eat them for breakfast during the week. It's quick and easy.
Nice.
But so Olive Oil's Pizza, don't forget them. They are fantastic. Our next guest, we're moving it back on up again. They've all been fantastic, but we're going into the world of violence, into the pugilistic world. And we're going to welcome at this time a three-time Golden Glove champion and a two-time state Golden Glove champion. Welcome at this time our next inductee into the Pittsburgh Sportsline 2019 class Hall of Fame, Colleen Davis.
guys' biggest fans.
We appreciate you. We just talked to you a couple weeks ago.
Yes.
Not much has changed except you got a suntan.
Yeah.
I see that.
Yes. I'm, I can't compete close. With you.
You're getting close. No competition here.
Yeah.
But it's like in the ring. You get hit and you come back hitting again.
That's right.
Right? I trust you.
That's right.
When's your next fight?
We have a fight going down in North Carolina at the Christy Martin tournament coming up.
Wow.
So it's a national tournament, so girls from all over the country will be there.
Are you ready?
Oh, yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
Good, because I'm a big fan. I like your punching style, and I like your movement in the ring.
Thank you. And you guys have been there. I think I said this last time I was on this show.
Say it again. We don't mind.
They were there for my first fight, and here we are 5 years later. You're still with me, and we're still friends. So. And thank you for, you know, always having us on your show, letting us get our, you know, we work so hard at this, getting our word out there. And I've met so many cool, wonderful, talented people.
Thank you.
You.
Well, we try.
Here, so.
We're the only show promoting sports people in our area.
Mm-hmm.
This is all about you, your boxing. Jose's having us back on the 15th. We'll be
all
at
right.
Ray Schaefer Boxing Association, 1017 Main Street, downtown Sharpsburg.
That's right.
Come there next Monday. So you'll get another chance to be on Pittsburgh Sportsline.
Oh, yes, yes. I love being on Pittsburgh.
Thank you. We'll have you back again. Congrats.
Hey, thank you so much.
Continued
it's an honor.
Success. Keep thank fighting you. Hard. Oh, that was thank a strong right.
Thank you.
She told me if I messed up her introduction, she'd beat the crap out of me. So I said, let's keep it short and sweet and simple. I need it. I just can't take it. My DJ career's
coming. She's going to hit you for general principle.
Huh? I don't blame her. That's how it works with me and the ladies.
Understood.
My DJ career is winding down. I'm going to have to ask Jim to help me out with this one. I still do DJ one night a week, Thursday nights. It's in Richland, Pennsylvania. It's wing night, and it's at what school?
Gateway!
It's the Gateway Inn Bar on
Why'd
Route 8.
Why'd you do that?
On Route 8. It's about 2/10 of a mile north of 910, about a mile south of Bakerstown, right across from Apple. We stop out, enjoy the wings. After they eat the wings, they have me chase them out with my music. And it is time for our last inductee into the Pittsburgh Sports Line.
How many brothers are there on Thursday?
Every once in a while.
Why is he bringing up the race?
We had one that cooked for a while, and he was a cook down at Atria's at the stadium. Loring West, the king of wing, the Wiccan of chicken, the prince of poultry, cooked there. Not anymore, but he did. He was a brother.
Thanks for helping him.
All right.
No, he heard you.
All right. Our final inductee is one of Pittsburgh's 50 finest, and that's not just Jim's list. She's a nationally renowned entertainer, 3-time Maxim magazine, and I marvel this. Maxim magazine is no small bananas. Maxim magazine is big time. She's a 3-time Maxim magazine model and an image and style influencer. She hails from Latrobe, Pennsylvania. She's performed internationally from stages of Vegas to the House of Blues, right back to her home turf here at Heinz Field. She's modeled for companies like some fly-by-night companies like Walgreens, Dick's, Fisher Price, things you never heard of, you know, minor little small companies. She's a national recording artist. She's returned home to become the first female to write and record an award-winning Pittsburgh Steeler fight song. She performed her hit I Love Black and Gold both live at the AFC Championship game and later at the Rock Steelers Style Fashion Show, honoring the late Dan Rooney, our next and final inductee into this stellar class of the 2019 Pittsburgh Sportsline Hall of Fame induction ceremony, Miss Natalie Sugars. I hope it's nice.
Congratulations.
Oh, long time no see.
It's been a while.
2 weeks?
Yes. Every other week we'll meet with you.
Every other week we should.
It's
absolutely
a pleasure.
Thank you, and it's an honor. Thank you so much. I truly appreciate you both and your friendship, and I know our professional, you know, relationship that we've had since I moved back here about 10 years ago. So thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you for all that you do, and we appreciate you.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And I won't tell everybody about how you missed the boat at my birthday party this
time. Please tell us again.
You can tell it again.
You really want me to?
Yes.
My ego's big enough.
Oh, what the heck? You know, it's only a Hall of Fame show once, and it was a Hall of Fame performance by Al Levine, the talking machine. So I have this party every year, and it's kind of the kickoff party to summer. And every year I theme it. You know, the first year it was a white party. You know, like P. Diddy. Then it was a black and gold party because I was turning 36. Use your imagination as to why. And then this year, it was the 50 Shades of Red party. So everyone's wearing red. So there's a theme. So you can notice where the party is. Unless your name is Al Levine. So Al shows up to the docks, and he's got his party tray. And he's got his, you know, little,
red,
like,
polo.
His little red polo on. Yes, exactly. And, you know, he's asking around, you know, where the boat is, you know, and whatnot, you know. And it's a large, large houseboat, you know, for this party. It, you know, it takes about 50 people out, and we pack it every year and have a great time on the Three Rivers. Al decides to get on this boat.
No, no, no. These guys at the dock told me it's down there at the end. The last boat at the end of the dock. What was I supposed to think?
Well,
I was
there
early.
Were two. So Al goes in, and he wanders in with his little said snack tray, and he puts it down, and all of a sudden he's going all through the boat, so the story goes, so I hear. And he's going all through the boat until he gets to the top, and he looks over, and he sees in the next boat that everybody is in red. He has no idea whose boat he's on. No clue. So then he got his little party snack tray and went over, and he actually caught the boat.
Yes.
Al Levine, everybody. Al Levine.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I love you.
I appreciate it. It's all true.
It's all true. It's all true. But no, thank you so much. And, you know, I've known you for such a long time. And funny enough, me and fashion shows, I swear to God, I've never done so many fashion shows in my life until I moved to Pittsburgh. And fashion is such a big part of my career, but I never really realized that it was, you know what I mean, with all the modeling and styling of shoots. And then from doing your fashion show to, you know, hosting, you know, the Fashion Alley fashion show, which I will find you the gold picture.
Just describe that dress. Or outfit that you wore in gold.
It's famous.
Please.
It's crazy. So James Houck, amazing fashion designer, which, by the way, October 18th, I will be hosting the next, yes, the Monster Madness crazy fun party.
Yes.
Yeah, so another fashion show coming up. And then, of course, I did Steeler's Style fashion show.
Sure.
So me, the black and gold, and the fashion shows. My goodness. It's like, you know, peanut
what
butter and jelly.
What was this? Explain.
It was a gold astronaut costume outfit. For the theme was Studio 54. That
from her neck to her toes.
And I even had a helmet and the whole thing. So James Houck is an amazing friend. He's also a world-renowned fashion designer who is from Pittsburgh, one of the nicest people that you'll meet. But he's super uber talented, and, you know, does stuff from the Academy Awards, the Zaras, and, like, so big time, big time. And we're backstage, and I put this outfit on. And I'm like, oh, my God, I felt like Britney in the Oops, I Did It Again video. I'm like, I think I did it again. You know, it was hilarious. So
your singing was unbelievable.
It was a good show. It was a really good show.
Cleopatra
that
being
was
held
fun.
By half-naked men.
I got carried in by half a dozen naked men singing Bad Girls. I mean, again, use your imagination. So
I was there.
He was there. He was there. He was there.
I made
there.
It for that.
You did. Yes, you did. Yes, you did. So it was a good time.
Show.
It was a good time. So lots of fun things. And now I got my own show. So this is crazy, right?
Tell them about your show.
Nat Around Town. You know, right now it's web-based. And, you know, I feature, you know, right now I'm just doing, like, more of, like, the weekend rundown. And I feature a small business and everything. And only seven or eight. Kayla, my PR girl, will kill me. But I think we're
Where's
seven.
Kayla
is not here. She's working. I need somebody to work where I'm doing this and hanging with you, right?
Yes.
So
we said hi.
I will. Kayla, hi. So, yeah, we're averaging about 4,000 views per episode already in the eighth episode in. So that's pretty big, you know, and and growing. And then I'm back hard at work in the recording studio, too, working on Vinny Vidivici, my album. So I'm kind of excited.
You came, you saw, you conquered.
I came, I saw, I conquered.
I got it.
Yes.
I know.
So thank you.
well,
thank you, guys. Love you lots. Oh, hug. Come on. I'm Italian. I hug.
Congratulations.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Jim.
Oh.
Come on.
I'll get in the middle.
I know. You're stuck. You're stuck.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Can I have one final?
Yeah.
Please. Before you do that, all right. Did we forget to mention international model Sindel Taylor in the house?
Of course, how could we forget? We're starting to work together at least annually. Something to look forward
She's
to
right
every
there.
Year.
You missed her.
It's one of the highlights of my year, just being in that general proximity of her presence. Hey, anyway, I think we showed Olive Oils tonight why it's valuable to have Pittsburgh Sportsline here. We filled this place. You guys filled this place, I mean. I want to thank all the guests that came to support the inductees. And could we hear it one time for all the Hall of Fame inductees, the 2019 class of Pittsburgh Sportsline Hall of Fame. Thank you so much for having me, guys. It's your show.
Thank you, Dan. You're the man. Great job, Smoking Jim.
Hey, thanks, Al Levine, the talking machine. This is an awesome night, and it was topped off always. You know, Sindel Taylor didn't get a chance, opportunity to talk.
Yes,
but
she did, right?
She'd been all around the world.
We'll bring her up. I wanted to see if you'd let her talk.
Hi, everybody.
Welcome aboard, Sindel. Tell them your name.
Welcome back. I'm so excited to be here. So for those of you guys who don't know me already, my name is Sindel Taylor, and I am the former Mrs. Pennsylvania America 2018. And if you didn't know me from that, I was Mrs. Allegheny County for 3 years running, 2015, 16, pretty much every year. I also ring girl. I've been a ring girl for about 10 years. Yeah, I've been around for a long time. I'm just so honored to be here. These guys have been grateful. I mean, I've been to all those places that you have been, even SIPs back in the day. So I've been around for a really long time on a lot of shows. I'm pretty sure I beat Zach's record from at this point. So, Zach, if you're watching.
I threw him on.
Well, if he's still watching, which he probably is, I know for sure I broke his record.
You're the champ.
Got to be the champ at something, so I'm excited.
You're my champ. I'm a fan of yours. You do a great job with this in spite of Smoking Jim.
Yeah, who forgets my birthday right after his birthday? Dual cake next year. That's what I'm asking
for.
Take
a slice home with you.
I will. But thank you guys just so much. They've always been here for me. So I really just appreciate being on this show. You guys have no idea how many doors and windows it's opened for me just as a model, as an advocate for heart health. It's just something I'm really passionate about. Absolutely, 100%. But before I leave, I have to share one announcement, which I don't know if anybody in this room has known. It's something really big. Pennsylvania was the 39th state that just passed that they are making it mandatory that all children learn CPR in high school now. And that's a huge feat. So I'm so excited to say that just because that's my personal platform. That's what I go out and talk about. And it took this long to pass it, but now children are going to have that opportunity. They can opt out, so I like to mention that too. But just think about the lives it can save. Definitely saved my life, you know, and a few other people's in this room.
Smoking Jim here.
So that's my, like, leave a thought. If you don't know CPR, please learn it. It will save somebody's life one day. So thank you so much again for letting me come on and just be here every year.
You're welcome. We're fans of yours. Thank you very much for your help.
Happy birthday, Smoking Jim.
We needed it. All right, I end each show with Stay Joey Strong.